Everyone, welcome to Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Today's topic is position of minor in Indian law. As you already know that we are already started the playlist for the subject business legislation. And started the Indian Contract Act. And also discussed various topics related to it like meaning of contract. Agreement, classification of contract and agreement, free consent, consideration, and so on. So in today's video, we'll discuss about the position of minor in Indian law. So what is the minor, meaning of minor, and what are the position we'll discuss here. You can also watch other videos related to it. Links are provided in the description box. And before starting the video, I want to say you that if you like my video, please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Now coming to the main topic, which is position of minor in Indian law. So what is minor? According to Indian Majority Act 1875, a minor is a person who has not completed 18 years of his or her age. However, where a guardian of a minor's person or property has been appointed under the Guardians and Wards Act 1890, or a court of wards has taken charge of minor's property during his or her minority, a minor will attain the age of majority after 21 years of age. So according to the Indian Majority Act 1875, all the person who has not completed 18 years of age comes under minor. In this case, the guardian of minor person taking the responsibility of that particular minor. So what is the position of minor in India law? There are following points in terms of position of minor in Indian law. First is, an agreement with or by a minor is absolutely void or inoperative. Second is, a minor can be a promisee or beneficiary. Third is, an agreement with a minor cannot be ratified. Fourth is, a minor cannot be asked to return any benefit enjoyed. Fifth is, a minor can always plead minority. Sixth, a minor can be an agent. Seventh is, a minor's estate is liable for necessaries supplied to him. Eighth is, a minor cannot be declared insolvent. Ninth is, a minor cannot be become partner, but may be admitted for the benefits of a partnership. 10th is, no liability of guardian for the acts of minor. 11th is, a minor may be bound by an agreement entered by his guardian for his benefits. 12th is, specific performances will not be granted against a minor. And the last is, a minor cannot become a member of a company. So these are the terms or points in terms of position of minor in Indian law. Now we are discussing each of the point one by one in detail. So first is, an agreement with or by a minor is absolutely void or inoperative. So a contract with a minor is absolutely void because minor is not able to do a contract according to Indian law. Second is, a minor can be a promissory or beneficiary. The intention of law is to protect the interest of minor. Hence, law permits a minor to be a beneficiary. He can be a promisee. An agreement, if it is beneficial to the minor, can be enforced against him. So, a minor can be beneficiary or promisee according to Indian Contract Act or Indian Majority Act for the interest of the minor. Third is, an agreement with a minor cannot be ratified. Ratification means subsequently authorizing an act. A minor cannot ratify a contract, otherwise it will defeat the very objective of granting protection to the minor. So what is ratification? It is authorizing the act to the minor. So a minor cannot ratify the contract, otherwise it will defeat the main objective of the protection of minor. Next is, a minor cannot be asked to return any benefit enjoyed. Since the agreement with a minor was void, so there was no question of any refund enjoyed by a minor. Next is, a minor can always plead minority. Even where a minor has misrepresented his age, that is, he has declared to other party that he was a major, he is not liable. So minor is not liable in any terms to do a contract or an agreement. Next is, a minor can be an agent. A minor can be appointed as an agent. An agent is only connecting link between the principal and the third party. As soon as a contract is established between them, the agent drops out and the principal and third parties are liable. The minor agent is not liable to the principal or to the third parties. So a minor can be appointed as an agent, which is a connecting link between principal and the third party. Next is, a minor's estate is liable for necessaries supplied to him. Under section 68, a minor's property is liable for the price of necessaries supplied to him. Necessary should be according to the standard of life of the minor, and he should be in need of them both at the time of contract as well as delivery. So according to the Indian Majority Act, under section 68, a minor's property is liable for the price supplied to him. Next is, a minor cannot be declared insolvent. Since a minor is incapable of binding himself, he cannot contract debts. Even for necessaries of life, he is not personally liable, only his property is liable. Therefore, if he has no property, payment cannot be recovered and he cannot be declared insolvent. So a minor cannot be declared insolvent in any of the case, as he is not liable for doing a contract or agreement of any type of property or anything else. Next is, a minor cannot become partner but may be admitted for the benefits of a partnership. To become a partner, a contract is necessary. A minor is incapable of entering into a contract, therefore he cannot become a partner. However, if all the partners of an existing partnership agree, a minor may be admitted to the benefits of a partnership. So, as a minor is incapable of doing a contract, so he cannot become a partner of any contract or agreement. But a minor may admit the benefits of a partnership also. Next is, no liability of guardian for the acts of minor. The guardian of a minor is not liable for the acts of a minor. However, where a minor is acting as an agent of the guardian can be held liable for the acts of minor. So the guardian can be liable in that case in which minor is working as an agent for the guardian. Next is, a minor may be bound by the agreement entered by his guardian for his benefits. A guardian may enter into an agreement on behalf of a minor. An agreement entered into by a guardian on behalf of a minor is valid and binding if it is within the powers of guardian. Such an agreement should be in the interest of the minor or should be for a legal necessity. So, a guardian may enter into an agreement on the place of minor, on the behalf of the minor, which is valid and binding with the legal obligations. Next is, specific performance will not be granted against a minor. A contract with a minor being void, specific performances will not be ordered by a court against him. So, as the minor cannot do a contract, so a contract done by minor is void and performance are not ordered by court against him. And the last is, a minor cannot become a member of a company. A minor being incompetent to contract cannot become a member of a company. If a minor, by misrepresenting his age, obtains shares in a company, the company can remove his name from the register of members after coming to know the fraud. So a minor is not capable to become a member of a company, it can come under a fraud case. So these are the points comes under the position of minor in Indian law. I again summarize all the points so that you can easily understand about the topic. basically minor is that person who has not completed the age of 18 years of the age. These are the points related to position of minor in Indian law. So a minor is not capable to doing a contract, it is declared void. A minor can be promissory or beneficiary, and he permits to become a beneficiary also. A minor cannot ratify a contract, otherwise it will defeat objective of granting protection to him. Next is agreement or doing by minor is void, so there is no question of refund enjoyed by the minor. Next is where the minor has represented his age as major, he has declared the other party that he was major, he is not liable to do a contract. If a minor is working as the agent of the guardian, so the guardian is liable in that case, but in this case, but minor can also work as a connecting link between the principal and the third party also. Seventh is, minor's property is liable for the price of necessary supplied to him. And according to standard of life, a minor should be need of both the time of contrast as well as the delivery. Next is, a minor cannot be declared insolvent in any of the case. Next is, a minor cannot become a partner, but he can enjoy the partnership also. Next is, there is no liability of minor in any of the case, but he is liable if he is working as the agent of the guardian. Next is, a guardian may enter into an agreement on behalf of minor. An agreement entered by guardian is valid and binding with the powers. Next is, a contract with minor being void, specific performance will not be ordered by court against him. And the last is, a minor is incompetent to do a contract and he cannot become a company's member. So these are the points comes in the position of minor in India law. If you have any query about this topic, or if you want to know about any of the topic related to research methodology, business legislation, human resource management, or any of the topic related to it, you can ask me through comment box. If you like my video, please like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. We'll meet in the next video with new topic. Thank you everyone.